Hi guys, so I'm going to do a little introduction before I move on to the tutorial. So hello, my name is Sarah and this is my first YouTube video. And for today, I will be giving you guys a tutorial on how to do all my TikTok edits, whether it's the Renaissance trend or a movie edit or a show edit. I'm here to teach you everything about what I do, from the outfit changes to how to do the transitions and to align your videos. And I'm here to do that with you today. So if you find this video very helpful, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Let's begin. So first you're going to head onto your TikTok and you're going to look for the time warp effect. The pose you make depends on who you're trying to impersonate. Like in this case, I'm trying to be Belle from The Beauty and the Beast and she's holding the beast. So I did this pose to resemble the actress. In order for you to not get the TikTok watermark, you're gonna go to the corner and screen record that video. Instead of posting it onto your TikTok, you're just going to screen record it and save it to your album. Now you're going to go to your album and you're gonna go to the end of the video and screenshot that picture. You will now need to go to PixArt and take that original picture so you can start editing it. So as you can see here, I am editing it and I had already started by adding stickers of Belle and the Beast so that I can do the outfit change first. So as you can see, I had to add two stickers prior to this to do the sleeves. And now I am working on the skirt and this took me a little bit longer, but it wasn't that bad. And you just want to get it to fit exactly to your body type. And as you can see here, I just add the same sticker several times until I make it as realistic as possible. The tools that I'm using here are the eraser option. As you can see, it depends what I'm working on, but I changed the opacity and the hardness to work on the edges of the stickers. After you are done editing the outfit and doing the whole editing of the stickers of the person you are working with, you're going to go to Google and look for stickers that you want, or you could even look on PixArt for photos that you want as your background. In this case, this is a photo that I chose, and as you can see, I'm just showing a little time lapse to show you quickly how I did it. Next, I'm working on hair, so I added hair to define my own hair because the resolution from the video is not the greatest. So here I'm doing the same thing as the outfit. I'm just working with the eraser option and I'm just changing the opacity to blend it in with my own hair. So next, I'm going to look for a black background to use at the top because I wanted to put the title of the movie and for it to stand out a little bit more. Next, I start looking for Beauty and the Beast stickers just to add in the background, just to make it nicer looking and just to make it my own edit. Now I go ahead and add the movie logo and I put a darker border so that you can make the logo more visible. Then I go to the beauty option and I choose skin color and I just brighten my face and my body for the picture just to make it a little bit nicer. And since the video was not the best quality, you would just want to make yourself stand out and look a lot better. Once you put the effects, it will look 100 times better. So trust the process. Here you can see me editing my hair just to match the Beast's hair. And then here I am adding detail to my face to define my face and make it clearer and for it not to look that blurry. I just continue adding stickers just to make it better. And now we're going to the fun part. Here I am adding filters. And as you can see, I'm just adding filters that fit best with my edit. So here I'm going for more goldish, yellowish tones and I'm just sticking to that. I applied a good 5 filters until I got the colors that I wanted, And now I am going to show you the fun part that everyone wants to know. So you're going to go to the magic option in the filters effects, and here are different artistic effects that you can go ahead and put onto your edit just to make it more like a painting. And so this is what a lot of people keep on asking me. And the truth is I use different effects on the magic option. And this is what helps my edit look like a painting. So I hope this helps, at least for the PixArt part. So here is my ending product. After you finish, you want to take this picture or this edit to VideoLeap. First, you want to upload your original video to VideoLeap. Next, you want to go onto the mixer option and place your edit on top of the video. Make sure to extend your edit all the way from the beginning of the video to the end of the video. An easy way to align your edit to your video is by going to the transform option and then pressing the fill in option. You should do this for your edit and your video, and it will automatically align both the edit to your video. You can check this by changing the opacity to 0 and to 100 just to make sure that it's perfectly in line, but this should work. It always works for me. After you align your edit to your video, you're going to go ahead and go to the mask option and choose a linear effect so that you can get this whole trend the way it's supposed to be. So in order to get the linear effect in a certain position, you are going to press on the keyframes. The keyframes are the diamonds located on the bottom right corner. And so these diamonds will just keep the linear effect at a certain point of the video. You are going to add these diamonds from beginning to the end of the video. Here's the rest of me editing this part so you guys can see how far it takes for me to add the little diamonds, so that you can have the better effect. You wanna do the linear effect in little parts. You don't wanna do big chunks apart from the editing, because then it'll chop off your video and it will look off. So here's the ending product. I hope this tutorial helped. And if you enjoyed this and if you found this helpful, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.